This is a Tetra-8-gon. It has four different faces, four colors, and it has four sides. It's a square made out of isosceles right triangles. And now I'm just folding along every line so that all the divisions between the triangles so that it will flex really well. Alright, now I'm going to fold the adjacent triangles of the same color on top of each other, so that's yellow on this side. And you see we have a zigzag, which is very common when you're in the middle of folding something up. And now I'm going to go green on green, because I want red to be on the outside, and red and blue to be on the outside of the square. Green on green. Green on green. And then white on white. Tape. And this flexagon has a complicated flex, but it's very important. It's important for other flexagons as well as this one. Let me just make this a little neater. Okay, so I'm gonna do the pinch flex from the blue side. Just very similar to what you do with a hexaflexagon. And it's opening on green. And for the green, can't do a pinch, so I'm going to do this complicated reverse pass-through flex. So I'm going to fold up on the diagonals of the square, so the hypotenuses of the triangles are up. And then I'm going to stop, and then I'm going to pull down panels of triangles all around this figure. And that will bring me to the next color, which is yellow. And then I can pinch, going from yellow to green. Can't move here, so I have to do this. So I went yellow, green. I'm passing through red. And I'm opening up to blue. Your screen again. I'm not going to see red until I flip this over, like that. So I'm going to flip it over, and now I'm going to pinch, and here's red. Now we're not going to see green fold out flat. I'll see green in passing, right here, but it's not going to fold out into the flat planar position. And here's yellow. And this should bring me back to red. There you go. And the reverse pass through, passing through green, and I'm going to be back on blue.